Bitcoin transcends any company, any CEO, any country. It's spreading everywhere, and it truly is the most successful decentralized technology human beings can point toward.
What are your thoughts on potentially, could Bitcoin ever be replaced by some other crypto?
I think there's about zero chance of that.
Bitcoin's
a trillion-dollar digital monetary network. Bitcoin would be the most successful thing you've ever seen in your life. Period.
That's a big one.
For example, it took Microsoft 44 years to be $1 trillion. It took Apple 42 years to be a $1 trillion network. It took Amazon 24 years to be a $1 trillion network. It took Google 22 years to be a $1 trillion network. It took Bitcoin 12 years to become a $1 trillion network. And there's nothing else.
Right.
There is no other $1 trillion network. So what you have is a decentralized digital network, which is in essence transforming analog money or analog assets to digital assets. It's global. It's running everywhere on the earth. And it has been growing. It was growing at 200% a year. Try to remember when Amazon or Apple or Google grew at 200% a year.
Yeah,
right?
Absolutely.
It's growing at 200% a year for a decade until March of 2020. And in March of 2020, that monetary fire that was burning at 200% a year hit the pandemic, and the rate of currency expansion increased by a factor of 3. We went from expanding the money supply at 7% a year to expanding the money supply at 24% a year. We're looking at the money supply expanding at 15% a year or more for the next 4 to 8 years. So how do you feed a monetary fire? And the answer is you pour money on it.
Right.
And so the macroeconomics are driving this network to grow faster. The network, it accelerated. It was growing 200% a year. Now it's growing 400%+ a year. Okay, again, give me an example of anything this scale that ever grew 400% a year. And in terms of inertia, the $1 trillion is $1 trillion of monetary energy. That means you've got more than 100 million people that have $1 trillion invested in this brand. This is the only brand in the history of the world. It's a $1 trillion brand, right? It's like think about the value of Coca-Cola as the brand. In the minds of 100 million plus people, you have this idea and it's worth $1 trillion. How are you gonna rip that idea out of people's heads? 100 million people, thousands and thousands of companies, huge amounts of energy, a huge amount of inertia. This is the base layer digital asset network that they're all focusing upon. And so as they build their technology around it, like Square and PayPal, and as they invest in it, like Tesla, and as the message spreads, that's a lot more energy and a lot more momentum than any company or any other brand or any other idea I've seen, right? I think 10,000 companies or 10,000 projects have attempted to displace Bitcoin. I think they've all failed.
Yeah.
The only way you're going to be successful with another crypto asset network is if you target a totally different use case than base treasury asset. So if it's a differentiated thing with a different market segment, a different use case, then perhaps. But in fact, the market has spoken. I'll say it again. In the history of the human race, we've never had a $1 trillion digital monetary network. It's the most successful thing humanity has created. It is creating value and gaining market adoption faster than anything that we can point our finger at in the history of the human race. So there's 100,000 entrepreneurs that would like to be Google or like to displace Facebook or like to displace iOS, and they're all going to have this is a better thing. But at the end of the day, if you're staring at a $1 trillion network that is more successful than everything you've seen in your life, that's growing faster than anything on earth, that's being adopted everywhere in the world, and you're going to then opt to ignore it in favor of a project in somebody's garage. I mean, it just seems irrational. when the other thing is 10 times as big as Bitcoin doing the same exact thing, then maybe it's logical. But right now the market is spoken, right? Yeah. And if you don't actually accept Bitcoin, then what do you think about Facebook, Google, Apple, and Amazon? Because those things are growing much slower with much weaker network effects right now. Right. Bitcoin transcends any company, any CEO, any country. It's spreading everywhere, and it truly is the most successful decentralized technology human beings can point toward.
Right.
So I don't know what else you'd point toward in terms of decentralization other than this. So,
well, I think the other things
they're ventures, and they're attempting to do something. And to the extent that they do something unique, they may find a constituency.
Yeah.
Well, it's a $1 trillion network. And that makes it 1/10 the size of gold.
Right.
And so and you're seeing it trading maybe $4-6 billion a day. Mm-hmm. So it's a suitable monetary network for a corporation or an individual that has a scale of investment in the billions or less. But if you wanted to store $10 to $100 billion, it's not quite big enough yet.
Gotcha.
And so there's a natural inertia. It takes a typical individual, it takes them 6 months from the point that they hear about Bitcoin to go through the educational process. And then from the point you decided you wanted to buy it, it would probably take you 12 weeks before you got comfortable with the on-ramp, the custodian, and the technique. Mm-hmm. For corporations, you double or triple that. Companies have corporate governance, they have compliance, they have board of directors. It would be, you know, certain companies, Tesla, they're lightning fast, but the typical company, they think that if they do something and it takes a year to get around to it, that was lightning fast. So the natural adoption cycle is going to be private companies, mid-size, early adopter, technical forward thinking public companies.
Right.
Then it will ripple. Normally, small or mid-sized countries, they're going to come last. I mean, before them will come big institutional investors and then the very conservative institutional investors. You know, the insurance companies have $7 trillion or something in assets. And so they'll probably be, you know, three levels from now. I think insurance companies right now have about $1 billion worth of Bitcoin exposure that we know of.
Right.
And you know, the next step would be for them to increase it by a factor of 10.
Sure.
But you can see, I mean, I wouldn't be holding my breath for the nation states first. I mean, nor do we really need to. Mm-hmm. This is a treasury asset.
Yep.
And so this is the solution to there's 100 million companies in the world, and there's 5,000 mega public companies, and there's 10,000 institutional investors that have $1 billion worth of capital or more. And so this is a lot more interesting for any of them at this scale. And I would think that the adoption will go from this point, from 1 trillion to 10 trillion, and then it'll creep up toward 100 trillion.
Right.
Somewhere between 10 and 100 trillion, you'll start to see small countries probably start to pay attention to it. But not right now. I mean, between 1 trillion and 10 trillion, this is like gold investors reallocating from gold, and silver investors reallocating from silver. And someone with a bunch of cash in a savings account saying, why don't I just put my money from a savings account into, you know, Bitcoin? And there's more than enough of that demand, you know, for the near next 2, 3, 4 years.
Yeah. Okay.